If you're not familiar with network ports, honestly, it's not all that surprising. The reason for this is because most of the time, network ports work automatically in the background, and you don't have to do anything with them. With that said, network ports are involved in any interaction between your connected devices and another device, and as you'll find out, there are some cases where you need to know what network ports are and how they work. So that's exactly what we're going to be diving into today. So at a high level, what are network ports? Network ports are basically channels that are used between two devices when they're communicating to make sure that traffic gets to the right place. Depending upon the activity that you're carrying out between these devices, a different port or channel will be used. For example, it's kind of like television at home. You'll have one channel for sports. If you want to watch cooking shows, you go to a different channel, or maybe you want to watch the news, that's another channel. It's important to make the distinction between network ports and physical ports. So for example, your router has physical Ethernet ports on the back of the device, but what we're talking about here are not physical ports when it comes to network ports. We're talking about logical ports that are identified in the software of your devices. And depending upon how these ports are used, different ports will be used for different activity. So, if you are sending email, that will use one port. If you are browsing the internet, that will use a different port. And even more so, if you're uploading files to a file server, that uses another port as well. There are many different ports to choose from, but basically what ports allow your devices to do is it allows your devices to carry out multiple things at the same time. So how do ports work? Well, ports are added to the end of IP addresses every time a device sends a request to another device. We'll get into this a little bit later when I show you an example, but this is the basics of how ports work. As I mentioned, there are many ports that your devices can use. All of your devices have a total of 65,535 ports that they can use. Now, these ports are broken up into three different categories. Ports 0 to 1023, those are known as well-known ports, and those ports are designated for specific services, much like surfing the internet with HTTP or HTTPS, file transfers. All of those are considered well-known ports, and you'll see a little bit more about those later. The next category that we're talking about here are called registered ports. These are ports 1024 to 49,151. These well-known ports are reserved for specific protocols or software, such as Oracle databases, OpenVPN, services like that. This last category of network ports are called private or dynamic ports. They're also known as ephemeral ports. These are port numbers 49,152 to 65,535. And these are the ports that get randomly assigned by devices when they're making requests to other devices. So basically, these ports get randomly selected each time your device, such as your computer, makes another request to another device. Again, you'll see this better when we go over the example and you'll have a better understanding of this. So if you're familiar with any network ports, they will probably be in the well-known ports category. That's because these are services that your devices are using all the time, and that's why these ports are reserved. For example, the most well-known ports that are commonly used are ports 80 and 443. These ports are used for internet communications. Port 80 is used for HTTP traffic to navigate to websites that are unencrypted. Port 443, which is much more common now as websites become more secure, but port 443 is for HTTPS, which is secure HTTP traffic. And that's why you see those all the time, because that's how most of the people use their devices. Other common ports, as I mentioned previously, with file transfers. The file transfer protocol, or FTP, uses port 21. Email that gets sent from one email server to another uses port 25, which is reserved for SMTP, Simple Mail Transfer Protocol traffic. Additionally, port 53 is used every time you want to use the domain name server and you're making a DNS request. So basically, when you type in a website like CNN.com, that request will go out over port 53 to find out what IP address CNN.com is, and that's how your computer figures out what destination to go to in order to access that website. Lastly, port 3389 is RDP, or Remote Desktop Protocol. So anytime someone remotes into your laptop or you're remoting into another laptop to make changes to it, that uses RDP on 3389. All right, let's look at an example of how network ports work so you can get a better understanding of them. Here, let's say we have a laptop in our home network and we would like to access CNN.com at this public IP address. So what happens is your laptop will put together a request to the web server. It will randomly select one of those ports that are in the private or dynamic port range. Here at random, we selected 49,155, and that is the source of the request. And because we're trying to access a website, and in particular, we're accessing a secure website, that's why the destination port needs to be 443. That's how this web server, when it receives this traffic from our laptop, it says, oh, okay, they're looking for the secure version of CNN.com. They're looking for a website. I know what to do with this traffic because of the port number that's been identified. Because the web server knows what to do with the traffic, it turns things around, it bundles that website up, and it sends it back to your laptop. So see, it's pretty easy and straightforward. It's basically just adding the port to the end of each IP address when a request is made. Now let's look at another example. And in this case, let's say we have our laptop again, but what we want to do is upload files to a file server online. So a similar process is followed here. Our laptop, to send a request, let's say it picks a different private or ephemeral port that it randomly assigns for this communication, 49,160. This request is going out to this online file server. So that's why the request uses port 21, which is a well-known port for file transfer protocol. That way, when the request gets to the file server, it says, okay, I know what to do here. This laptop is clearly trying to upload files to the file server. It identified port 21. I know what to do here. And then it goes, it returns that request. When those files are uploaded, it will say, everything's okay. I'm confirming the upload of those files. As you can see here, the process is pretty much the same. The only thing that changes will be that source port that gets randomly assigned for each communication, and then the destination port based upon the service that you're using. So when is this information helpful? When do you need to know what port numbers you're using? Well, as I mentioned in the introduction, most of the time, you don't need to know what ports you're using. That's because a lot of this happens in the background, and you don't have to make any configuration changes in order for everything to work properly. With that said, there are a few instances where you need to know what port numbers you're using, specifically if you're setting up port forwarding for online gaming or accessing a device on your home network. That's where you need to know what port you need to forward and what service you're going to be forwarding with port forwarding. If you want to see how that works, I've made another video that details how port forwarding works, but that's an instance where you absolutely need to know what port you're using. On top of that, if you're having trouble with, say, a VPN or a database connection, you might need to know what port you're using, and you might need to change that port in order for the connection to work properly. In addition to that, if you need to make changes to the firewall in any of your devices, obviously, this firewall is tied to the different services in different ports of your devices. So if you need to open up a firewall rule, you need to know what port you want to open that firewall rule for, and that's where knowing the ports that you're using is critically important. I'd love to see in the comments section if this cleared network ports up for you, and hopefully you'll have a good understanding of how they work moving forward. As always, thanks for checking out this episode from Network from Home, and we'll catch you on the next one.